Dear students, in this video I am going to explain how to calculate plastic section modulus and plastic moment capacity of a section. The property of plastic neutral axis is that area on the both side of the plastic neutral axis is equal. Whether it is upper side or lower side, the area will be equal, and therefore we can also say that this is area on the either side will be half of the total area. So this is a property which is used several times while calculating the section modulus. So in this case we can see that this section about major axis is symmetrical. So when we see this is symmetrical, so we can assume, or we simply know that the plastic neutral axis lies at the location of symmetry, or plane of the symmetry. In this case, this is on the half of the depth of the section. So that is the next thing. And in this case, when a symmetrical section, this is easily known. So here we can see that we have to find out this on different areas, as well as to find out section modulus, we also have to know the distance of centroid of that area from plastic neutral axis. So here we can see that upper area, that is formed of two segments. One is wave segment and other is upper plane segment. So when we calculate wave segment, that is d by 2 minus thickness of our flange. So at a length of wave on the in the upper area will be half of the depth minus upper flange, thickness of our flange, and that will be multiplied by thickness of wave. So that's how we find out 1036.64 mm square as area. Here in this video, all the dimensions have been shown in millimeters. I have shown it only at a few places, otherwise by default it has to be taken as a millimeter. So the distance of the centroid of A1W, which is a wave segment in the upper area, has to be taken in the mid height of that segment because of uniformity. So we can say that 0.5 multiplied by d by 2 minus tuf is the distance of centroid of that segment from plastic neutral axis. So that comes out to be 68.2 mm. Now similarly, if we find out area of our flange, that becomes width of flange multiplied by thickness of flange. So that becomes 1224 mm square. Here that segment which is common to wave and flange has been considered in the flange only, to avoid repetition. And similarly, here we can see that distance of centroid of the upper flange area from the plastic neutral axis is d by 2 minus tuf upon 2, that is 143.2 mm. So after, once we have found out these, we also know that because of symmetry, the same values of area and y1 will be available in the lower side also. So now we are moving further. So whatever moment, or whatever first moment of the area will be calculated on the upper side, the similar will be repeated in the lower side. So that is why plastic section modulus z, while we are calculating z, we are multiplying it, we are multiplying the area with the distance from distance of centroid from PNA, and we are after calculating it for the upper side, to incorporate the lower side, we are simply multiplying it by 2. So that's how we find out Z, about Z, that is section modulus, plastic section modulus basically. And about Z, Z is 491945.8 mm³. Now to find out plastic moment capacity, that is simply Fy into Zp. Fy is yield strength of the steel, and that is multiplied by Zp, so that is 250 into 491945.8, so that comes out to be 122.986 kN into meter. So here we can see that once we have found plastic section modulus about major axis, we may also need to calculate plastic section modulus about minor axis. So in this case, when we look at the axis or direction, here we see that there is no symmetry. So in this case, we have to find out or calculate the plastic neutral axis. To calculate that, again, it is the same approach has to be used, and that is that area on the either side has to be equal, or we can also say area on the either side has to be half of the total area. So now we see that first we can assume that area distance of plastic neutral axis, which here is being shown as yy line, from the bottom of the channel, or the leftmost side of the channel, is taken as A, and therefore we have to start, we are assuming it A, because in this case we do not know what is the location of PNA. So we are assuming a location where we can start our calculations, and we are also assuming that A is greater than thickness of wave. So we are saying that PNA lies outside the wave. So here it is a quick check which I am applying here, that area of the wave is 2280 mm², while area of flange is 2241.3 mm². Here just by looking at these two areas, we can see that wave area is greater than flange area. So the PNA has to lie within the wave, because wave is a greater area. So half of the area will be within, like half of the area will be only due to wave, and remaining half will be because of both the flanges and little bit of wave. But however, and the total area is 4521.3 mm². Now just to explain how to do with the iterations here, in this case I can by looking at the wave area and flange area, I can simply say that the PNA lies within the wave. However, to explain you how to do with iterations and to find out location of PNA, I am assuming it to be outside of. Now we can see that either left side of the area or right side of the area has to be equal to each other, and they have to be equal to A by 2. So now I am taking case of the left side, right side of the area, and half of the area. So second, you can say the right side or half of the equation. Here we can see that while solving this equation, we find out A, value of A is negative. That means that our assumption is not correct. So now, as our first assumption does not work, so we have to go for iteration, and we are assuming the second case, which is the PNA lies inside the wave. So A is less than TW. In this case, the left area will be having wave only, and the right area will be having wave as well as flange. So in this case, Again, we will be calculating the area. Similarly, that left area A1 is 300, which is depth of the section, and A, which is distance of PNA from the left most portion. And that 300 into A must have, like I have shown you the calculation of the right area also, but that is not, I am not interested into that, because the first case 300 into A gives me a very simple equation to solve. If we look at the condition of the PNA, that A1 is equal to A by 2. So here I can calculate A1 is equal to 7.5355, and as I see that A1 is not negative, also A1 is less than TW, so my solution is correct, because it holds true for the assumed premises. Here plastic section modulus, to calculate plastic section modulus now, I can calculate the left area, which is D into A, and that comes out to be 2260.64. Actually, that is half of the area, again, half of the total area. Then centroid of the left, that is centroid of the left area from PNA, that is A by 2, and so that is 3.76775 mm. Now on the right side, there are two segments. One is web area and second is flange area. So for the web area and flange area, we will be calculating area of the segment as well as the distance of centroid of the area segment from PNA. So both of them has been explained here, shown here. You can see, and while I suggest you to do calculate by on your own, so that you can match it by keep pausing the video. You should pause the video, you should check your calculations with this. Then now calculating plastic section modulus. So plastic section modulus is summation of area segments, different area segments, and multiply it by the respective distance of centroid from PNA. So area AI represents different area segments, and YI represents different distances of centroid from PNA. So that is shown here. So this equation 2, this equation has to be ignored. This is a mistake, that 2 into A1 W by 1 W plus A1 U by 1 UF. This has, unfortunately, this has come from the previous equation. So ZYY can be calculated by there are three segments. So for all the three segments has to be considered this way. And total plastic section modulus about YY comes out to be 101003.5 mm³. And similarly, the plastic moment capacity, that is Fy into Zp, can be calculated. That comes out here to be 252.5 kN into meter. Thank you.